pi into beta 0 plus beta 1 x, where x is a temperature. And our aim is that given a temperature, what will happen to probability of failure? So we wish to identify this. So of course the model is developed, and when the model is fitted using the iteratively.
Sir,
screen
showing.
Sir, screen नहीं हो रहा है.
नहीं दिख रहा है sir.
नहीं हो रहा है.
Sir, meet का केवल दिख रहा है आपका. Meet का page.
Okay, हमने stop screen कर दिया इसलिए. अभी दिख रहा है?
हाँ सर.
Yes
sir.
हाँ सर अभी दिख रहा है.
Yes sir. We were talking about the response. Is the binary. It is a problem of a space shuttle which is exploded into the Atlantic. It is exploded into the oceans of the Florida, and it was identified that the failure of the space shuttle is due to the failure of the rocket boosters, and rocket booster is failed due to the O-ring has lost its flexibility at the low temperature. So the study is conducted what happened to the O-ring when the temperature is at the Fahrenheit level. So there are different temperature level the experiment is conducted, and it is identified that whether at least one O-ring is failed or not. So one means if at least one O-ring failed, zero means none of the O-ring is failed, and response is measured in the terms of a binary, y equal to 1 for the at least one O-ring failed, y equal to 0 when there is no failed O-ring. And x is nothing but it is a quantitative variable. The variable name is a temperature, and which is measured in the Fahrenheit. So because the response is binary, we wish to apply the binary logistic regression, and I am interested to obtain the estimate of beta 0 and beta 1 so that I can get the expected value of the response or the probability of the O-ring failed. So we have already seen that we have applied the iteratively reweighted least square method to obtain the estimate of the parameters beta 0 and beta 1. So when we perform the IRLS method, the estimate of beta 0 is 10.87, and estimate of the beta 1 cap is nothing but minus 0.17, and this is nothing but the probability that expected, e power beta 0 plus beta 1 cap x divided by 1 plus e power beta 0 plus beta 1 cap x. So this is the expected probabilities obtained. Either you can have used this one or this form. Both the forms are of the same in nature. Okay, total how many observations? So 24 observations were the 7s which are failed and 17 which are not failed. So they are said to be events, and these are nothing but the estimate of beta 0, estimate of beta 1. These are the coefficient value. This is the corresponding standard error, and take the ratio of coefficient divided by the standard error, it is giving the Z and corresponding p value. So you can say that the beta 0 is statistically 0. That means say at 5% you can say that the null hypothesis is accepted. But what about the beta 1 equal to 0? So that hypothesis is rejected at 5% level of significance. That means the temperature has the impact on the O-ring failed. And because there is a negative sign, so it is indicating that as the temperature is increased, the probability of failure is decreasing. Okay, that means probability of failure is decreasing. It means that the higher the temperature, there is a less chance of the failing of the O-rings. And if you find out the Oort's ratio, so how to find out the Oort's ratio? I told you that Oort's ratio is nothing but e power of beta 1 cap. So beta 1 is, in our case, it is a point minus 0.017. If you take e power, you will get the Oort's ratio is 0.84. And 0.84, it means that 1 minus Oort's ratio cap into 100 percentage. If odds ratio is less than 1, then you have to 1 minus into this. Otherwise, if odds ratio is greater than 1, then odds ratio minus 1 into 100%. So it is nothing but the 1 minus 0.84 into 100%. It means it is a 16%. So it is saying that as you increase temperature with 1 unit, then the probability of odds or the odds of failure decrease by 16%. Okay, so that is what we have discussed. And why it is a e power beta 1? So I told you that we usually write the linear predictor is eta of xi is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 xi. And if we add the 1 unit in the xi, let us say xi is a temperature. If I will add 1 unit, then it is a xi plus 1 unit. So eta xi plus 1 is nothing but beta 0 plus this. If just take the difference of these two, what happens? Beta 0 is cancelled out and beta 1 xi is cancelled out. So you will get only beta 1 or the B1. And what is the linear predictor? So we already said that the theta is equal to log of pi upon 1 minus pi is compared with the linear predictors. So wherever the eta is there, we have to write down the corresponding logit. So this is nothing but the logit at log of odds at x plus 1. Why odds? Because it is a pi upon 1 minus pi is known as a odds, and minus log of odds at xi. So it is a difference. So log of odds xi plus 1 upon odds of xi is nothing but this is nothing but the b1. So it is written as a B1. So what is the odds ratio? If you are just changing the 1 unit of, so it is the odds ratio is become the e raised to B1. Okay. And that is how, if we are changing the independent variable from xi to xi plus 1, what kind of the change we observe in the odds ratio, it is known as a e raised to b1. If b1 is greater than 0, odds ratio is greater than 1. Because if we take the b1 equal to 0, e raised to b1 equal to 0. And if b1 is less than 0, odds ratio is less than 1. And at b1 equal to 0, odds ratio is 1. Because e raised to b1 0, e raised to 0 is equal to 1. So in our case, what is the odds ratio? What is the sign of this regression coefficient? It is a negative. So therefore, odds ratio was less than 1. And that is how, while comparing this, we have just taken the 1 minus odds ratio. And that you can also observe from the table as well. Okay. So now, once you get the odds ratio, suppose if you are increasing, instead of 1 unit, if you are increasing the, let us say, pi unit, or let us say k d unit, then what happens? If we are increasing the phi unit, then we have to simply multiply the phi with this beta 1, and then we have to take the odds ratio or exponent of that. Okay, so it is giving that exponent of phi b1, if you take d equal to phi. Why it is the case? Because if we are writing instead of 1, we are writing here phi. What happened? If we are changing the phi unit, then here it is a phi, and if here it is a phi, that means this is nothing but the b0 cancel, b1 xi will be cancelled, and b1 into phi. So here it is a phi. So it is a phi b1. Okay. And that is how it is log odds ratio is nothing but the phi b1. So if I wish to see that what odds is changing, if I am changing in the xi, so if I am changing xi with the d unit of measurement, the odds is increasing 5 times. Not the 5 times of 0.84, it is a e power of phi into the quantity. Okay. And almost if you, in that way, if you are comparing, if you are multiplying this with the phi, what happens? It is a 0.42. And if you are taking this e raised to phi, this again it is a 0.22. So this indicates that what is the odds of failure? The odds of failure is decreased by 1 minus 0.42 into 100%. It means it is a 0.58. So that is nothing but D. In terms of a percentage, it is a 58%. The odds of failure is decreasing with 58% as you are increasing the 5 unit of degree of temperature. So whatever the odds ratio we obtain in the logistic regression and the 2x2 contingency table, that is widely used in the categorical data analysis. So there is some connection. Odds ratio obtained through the logistic regression and odds ratio obtained using the categorical data analysis. So if you remember in our model, we have written something pi 00, pi 11, pi 10, and pi 11. Okay, this is absence, this is presence, exposure absence, exposure present. And then we have calculated the odds ratio. The odds ratio is nothing but the P00 into Pi11 upon Pi10 into
Pi01 aayega na sir wahan pe second element.
This is a Pi01, sorry. This is a Pi01. So it is the ratio of diagonal element to, sorry, it is a product of diagonal divided by the product of off diagonal. So that is giving the odds ratio. And if we have considered in terms of a frequency, we have considered it is a A, B, C, D. Then we say that AD by BC. That is nothing but the odds ratio. So in short, whenever you are finding in a 2x2 contingency table, how will you find out the odds ratio? It is the ratio of just product of diagonal element divided by the product of off diagonal element. So let us understand this and how it is connected with the odds ratio which we are obtaining through the binary logistic regression. So aisa aapko puch sakte hai na ki what are the relation between the odds ratio obtained in the logistic regression and the in a 2x2 contingency table when the data are of ordinal in nature. So let us understand with one example. In following table, represent the 2x2 contingency table where the categorical response variable represent the outcome. So we have a two variable. One is the outcome variable. Outcome means whether the person is infected or not infected for a group of patients treated with the either active drug or placebo. So now the patient is with you and you have given the active drug. We call them as a zero. And we have given the placebo. Placebo means it is a kind of a look like as a drug, but it has only
copy.
Okay. So for example, if a patient come to the doctor will give the particularly, let us say, capsule of a red color and the yellow color. Patient has idea that patient has taken the drugs, but only the doctor has idea that whether it is a drugs or the placebo. Placebo means it has the glucose within that. There is no active drug content is that, but it is to patient has the psychology. No, doctor has given the drug, and then we try to see that how many patients are cured without the drug. Okay, and active drug means some active drug content is available. Just for example, to control the fever, paracetamol content is there. So if that content is there, that means that drug is of a active drug. Again, the drug is look like is the same. It is of a yellow and red capsule. Patient has no idea whether he or she has taken the drug or placebo. Now, why is the response that the patient is not affected? Y equal to once the patient is infected. So you have a response of two nature. One means infected, and Y takes value zero is not infected. Okay. So, and you have taken, it is again a binary variable, treatment. So treatment is nothing but binary. It is taking one and zero. One means you have given the placebo, okay, and you have given the active drug. So it is a dummy variable. We have considered as a 1 means placebo is given, 0 means active drug is given. So how many patients who has given the active drug and they are not affected? So they are N00. How many patients who has given the active drug and they are affected, infected? So they are N10. How many patients, or in other way, you can say that how many patients who are not infected and you have given the placebo? So that is the N01. How many patients who are infected and then you have given the placebo? They are N11. Okay, because drug and placebo kab diya jata hai? In a retrospective study when the patient come to the hospital. So isliye aapko bataya tha ki yahan pe aapka kya hai? Ki infected and non-infected disease hai. Aur usme se infected nahi hai. Phir bhi aapne drug diya, active drug. To kitne patient aise? N00. Infected nahi hai. Still you have given the placebo, that how many patients are there? They are N01. The patients are infected and you have given the active drug. So how many? They are N10. And similarly, infected hai and you have given the placebo. How many? They are N11. So according to the categorical analysis, contingency table, what is the odds ratio? I told you that product of
N01.
Diagonal value N00 N11. Divided by the product of and diagonal, sorry, off diagonal value.
Off diagonal element.
N10 into N0. So this is the odds ratio that you are usually obtaining through the contingency table. You do not require any software. Okay. And if you know the odds ratio, can you obtain the estimate of beta? Yes. Log of force ratio is giving the estimate of beta. Is that okay? Okay. Let us come to that part. So this is saying that in a 2x2 contingency table, it is a force ratio of odds of infected divided by the placebo drug. So that is N11 by N00. Okay. So infected hai. उसमें आपने क्या किया है? N10 डिवाइड बाय सॉरी हाँ तो आपने एक्सपोजर प्रेजेंट है, एक्सपोजर एब्सेंट है, ठीक है. तो आपने प्लेसबो दिया है एंड एक्टिव ड्रग दिया, तो रेशियो क्या है? N11 बाय N01. And similarly, sorry, yahan pe jayega. We are just talking about the placebo. Infected to, it is a ratio of infected to non-infected when the placebo is given. So N11 by N01. Aur yahan pe kya aayega? N10 by N00 when the active drug is given. So you can see that. N10 by N00. Okay, so that we can obtain the odds ratio. So kisme baat kiya? Ek aapne liya. प्लेसबो का, किसमें से? इन्फेक्टेड टू नॉन इन्फेक्टेड. दूसरा लिया एक्टिव ड्रग, इन्फेक्टेड टू नॉन इन्फेक्टेड रेशियो. तो दिस इज द रेशियो ऑफ प्लेसबो टू एक्टिव ड्रग. तो वही लिखा है ऑड्स ऑफ इन्फेक्टेड. ऑड्स ऑफ इन्फेक्टेड मींस इन्फेक्टेड डिवाइड बाय नॉन इन्फेक्टेड. ऑड्स ऑफ इन्फेक्टेड फॉर एक्टिव मींस इन्फेक्टेड पेशेंट डिवाइड बाय नॉन इन्फेक्टेड. वी हैव गिवन द एक्टिव ड्रग. Now, if you are considering the binary logistic regression, we have a treatment is a 1 variable, but we have considered a treatment as a dummy variable. Okay, so we have considered the 1 beta 0 as a linear predictors. Beta 0 is intercept, and here it is a beta 1 x1, where x1 takes value 2, 1 and 0. 1 means active placebo and 0 means active drug. So if no drug is given, then what happen? Suppose if you are substituting x1 equal to 0 in this, what will you get? Yahan pe x1 ki value 0 rakhenge to kya hoga? x1 0 hai to beta 1 component hi chala jayega. To kya bacha? Beta 0 equal to ln pi upon 1 minus pi. So that means pi kya hai? When probability of pi equal to 1, yahan pe x1 kya rakha hai? 0. And probability of y, 1 minus pi kya hua, probability of y equal to 0 when x1 equal to 0. So what is the estimate of b0 or beta 0? It is a ln probability of y equal to 1 given x1 equal to 0 divided by probability of y equal to 0 given x1 equal to 0. And when you take x1 equal to 1, what will you get? Yahan pe 1 rakho do, kya milega? It is a beta 0 plus
beta 1.
And isme baat kar raha hai, to we are talking about the probability that patient is infected when placebo is given by the probability of the patient is not infected when placebo is given. So this is the logic of this. And when we have calculated logic, because when the placebo is given, so we have find out that logic, and this is nothing but what happened, beta zero we have obtained this quantity, and x1 equal to 1, so it is a plus b1. Okay, so this is nothing but my beta zero we have obtained, and here we substitute x1 equal to 1, I will get the beta 1. So solving this, how will you solve this? Take this as a left hand side, so it become the minus. Can be write in this way, log of what is that? This is ln y equal to 1 given x1 equal to 1 divided by probability of that. This is the probability of y equal to 0 given x1 equal to 1. Okay. Minus kya likh rahe hain? Ln y equal to 1, that is the probability of given x1 equal to 0 divided by probability of y equal to 1
equal to 3.
Y equal to 0, x1 equal to 0. Okay, so of course this is a minus, so in a log we know that it is a just ratio. So what happened, it is a ln probability of y equal to 1 given x1 1, what we say, let us, we call them as a, keep it as it is. What do we say? In our set, let us say it is a pi 1 1 into upon kya hai? It is a pi 0 1. Okay. Into kya hoga? So ye minus hai, to minus ka kya ho jayega? Ratio, that means it is a pi 0 0 upon pi 1 0.
Pi 1 0.
1 0. So what will you get? It is a ye multiply hai. Theek hai, to kya hua? It is a pi 1 1 into pi 0 0 divided by pi 0 1 into pi 1 0. Aur dono mein sample size to same hi hai. तो अगर इसको हम सैंपल साइज के स्ट्रक्चर में लिखेंगे तो क्या होगा, वी कैन राइट इट एज ए एन 1 1 इंटू एन 0 0 डिवाइड बाय एन 0 1 इंटू एन 1 0. सो सी दैट वेदर वी आर गेटिंग सेम. ओके, तो दैट मींस बीटा 1 इक्वल टू दिस. सो ओड्स रेशियो क्या हुआ, दिस इज माय ओड्स रेशियो इन ए बाइनरी लॉजिस्टिक, सॉरी इन ए कंटिजेंसी टेबल. So this is nothing but the here ln is that, so it is a e raised to beta 1. So when you have a binary logistic regression, if you are finding out the odds ratio from the categorical data analysis and from the binary logistic regression, you will get the same odds ratio. Okay, same you will try na, yes or no?
Yes sir.
So you are getting the same odds ratio, but it is saying that ki logistic regression se jo aapko milega, whatever the odds ratio you are obtaining through logistic regression, it is much more general than the traditional 2x2 contingency table. So why it is much more general? So it is saying that earlier what happened, we have only taken the whether the patient is given the placebo or active drug. But do you feel that only the placebo or the drug is responsible to cure the patient?
No.
लेकिन हमने कंटिजेंसी टेबल में तो क्या लिया, सिर्फ दो ही वेरिएबल लिए, बट इन प्रैक्टिकल देयर आर सो मेनी अदर फैक्टर्स व्हिच आर अफेक्टिंग योर रिस्पांस. लेट अस से इफ आई एम सेइंग दैट एज ऑफ द पेशेंट, सो अंडर द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द एज व्हाट शुड बी द इंपैक्ट ऑफ द ड्रग्स और द प्लेसेबो और द प्लेसेबो ओवर द ड्रग्स. इफ आई विश टू ऑब्जर्व, I could not able to get this from the contingency table, or if I wish to make, some of it is little bit difficult. So here you can see that, for example, in logistic regression can incorporate other predictor variables, and the presence of these variables can impact the odds ratio. So suppose if you are other variables are there, and if you are adding these variables, of course your odds ratio is affected. For example, suppose that another variable x2, what is the name of that variable x2 is nothing but age, is available for each patient in the drug study. Okay, so this is the data, and if I have the information about the patient of the each patient's age, then if I will not consider, then I may have a loss of information. So if I have to consider, then I have to add the age as a variable. So in that case, my logistic regression having the linear predictor is x1 is nothing but the whether the it is a placebo or active drugs, and x2 is the age. So my linear predictors become the multiple linear predictors. Earlier it was a simple linear predictors, itna hi tha na. Now we have added the one variable, more variable, so my linear predictors become the beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. And again, if you are allow this linear predictor age to impact the estimate of odds ratio for a drug variable, the odds ratio is still odds ratio to kya milega aapko, e raised to beta 1 hi milega, but the estimate of beta 1 is potentially affected by the inclusion of x2 variable. जरूरी नहीं है कि बीटा वन जो हमें लीनियर प्रेडिक्टर्स में मिला बीटा जीरो प्लस बीटा वन एक्स में, द सेम एस्टिमेट विल रिमेन अंडर द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द एज. ओके, इट विल आल्सो पॉसिबल टू इंक्लूड द इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन द एज एंड द मॉडल. सपोज कि सर्टन पेशेंट है, कि सर्टन एज है, तो प्लेसेबो की इम्पैक्ट क्या है, दैट इफ आई विश टू स्टडी द इंटरेक्शन टर्म, तो आई हैव टू ऐड द वन मोर टर्म x1 x2. So in this model, the odds ratio for the drugs depends on the level of age and would be computed as a e power of beta 1 plus beta x2. So suppose aapko dekhna hai ki what is the impact of the age on the odds of infected of the patient, then the form is, yahan pe maine beta 2 nahi likha hai, kya likha hai, beta 1 2. Beta 1 2 means there is the impact of the age on the treatment about the patient is cured or not. So beta 1 2 is nothing but it is the interaction of that. What it's saying that odds of ratio for the drug depends on the level of age and would be computed as, so this is the odds for only the treatment, but simultaneously you are adding the interaction effect, that means the effect of the age. So the odds become the e power beta 1 plus beta 1 2 x2, and this is known as the adjusted odds ratio. So in contingency tables it is simply a odds ratio, but in binary logistic regression we call them as a adjusted odds ratio. And how to obtain the adjusted odds ratio? So we have to add the interaction effect while calculating the odds ratio. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So the interpretation of regression coefficient in a multiple logistic. So ye ho gaya multiple logistic kyunki ek se zyada aapke paas regressor hai. So it is not a simple logistic, it is a multiple logistic. So the interpretation of regression coefficient in a multiple logistic regression model is similar to that for case where the linear predictor contain only one linear regression. That is, the quantity e raised to beta j is the odds ratio of regressor xj, assuming that all variables are constant. So jaise hum multiple linear regression mein lete the partial regression coefficient, so beta j is nothing but it is a partial regression coefficient, and when you take e power beta j, it is nothing but the it is the odds ratio for regressor xj, assuming that all the other predictors are constant. Okay, so what is the difference between the odds ratio and adjusted odds ratio? What is the difference? So in adjusted odds ratio, what happens? We have these other variables which are affecting your response. Okay, so we try to study that what is the impact of that variables together while calculating the odds ratio of the x1. So it is known as a odds ratio, adjusted odds ratio. Okay. So वो बाइनरी लॉजिस्टिक आपको एडजस्टेड ऑड्स रेशियो कहाँ मिलेगा? सिर्फ बाइनरी लॉजिस्टिक में. दैट यू कैन नॉट कैलकुलेट थ्रू दी
कंटिंजेंसी टेबल.
कंटिंजेंसी टेबल. इज दैट क्लियर?
यस सर.
तो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द ऑड्स रेशियो फ्रॉम द कंटिंजेंसी टेबल, हाउ टू कैलकुलेट ऑड्स रेशियो यूजिंग द बाइनरी लॉजिस्टिक रिग्रेशन, व्हाई इट इज ई पावर बीटा वन, what happened to the odds ratio, whether the odds ratio remained the same if we calculate the from the contingency table and the binary logistic regression. Yes, provided only one regressor is there. But if there are multiple linear regressions are there, then the odds ratio of xi or the ith variable is affected due to the presence of the other variables. And if you are looking for the adjusted odds ratio, that means you are trying to adjusting the effect of the age. Let us say, what is the odds ratio of the patient for the curing who have given the placebo compared to the active drug? When the patient age is 40 years, then you have to just write the x2 equal to 40 over here. The coefficient of age is you have already obtained, and coefficient of the placebo versus active drug is with you. So that gives the odds ratio. What is the status of the patient whose age is 40? Of the curing who has given the placebo compared to the active drug. And if that odds ratio is greater than one, it is suggesting that for this age, the placebo working better than the active drug. But if odds ratio is decreasing, it means that the placebo has the reverse effect or the inverse effect compared to the active drug. That means the active drug has a positive impact for reducing the infected number of patients. तो ये सारे आपको जैसे पूछा जाएगा एग्जाम में, तो ऐसे व्हाट इज द एडजस्टेड ऑड्स रेशियो, सपोज ऐसा मॉडल दे दिया है कि व्हाट इज द फॉर्म ऑफ एडजस्टेड ऑड्स रेशियो इन दिस सेटअप. ओके, तो कुछ ऐसा एक्सप्लेन किया जाएगा, आपको पूछा जाएगा कि भाई व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द ऑड्स रेशियो एंड एडजस्टेड ऑड्स रेशियो, तो दैट यू हैव टू गिव द इन अ वन लाइन आंसर. Whether the if you are obtaining the odds ratio for the binary logistic regression and odds ratio using the contingency table, whether it is same or not. If it is same, under which condition it is same? If it is not same, under which condition it is not same? True, false. So then if you are saying the true, then you have to justify why. If you are saying the false, then you have to justify why. So this kind of the questions may ask in the internal test. तो ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि सर हमारा एक मॉडल टेस्ट ले लो, बाद में हमें पता चले, ठीक है? ओके, अप टू हियर एनीवन हैज एनी क्वेश्चंस? एनीवन?
नो सर,
नो सर.
एवरीबॉडी इज लिसनिंग द सेशन?
यस यस सर.
ओके, यस सर, यस सर.
प्रॉब्लम नहीं हो रहा है ना, समझ में
आ रहा है? नहीं सर.
हम ट्राई तो ऐसा ही कर रहे हैं कि क्लासरूम में पढ़ा रहे, ऐसे ही हम बोर्ड की जगह पे स्क्रीन का यूज कर रहे हैं, ठीक है? बीच बीच में जो आपको डेरिवेशन से वो बता रहे हैं, लेकिन आपको साथ में नोटबुक लेके बैठे तो ही काम का है. फिर बोलेंगे कि सर हम इसको वीडियो को देख लेंगे फिर उस टाइम पे बनाएंगे, तो मतलब नहीं है, क्योंकि एक घंटे का वीडियो देखना बड़ा मुश्किल हो जाता है. ओके, आगे बढ़ते हैं. So, of course, the once the estimation part is done, we always go for the testing of hypothesis. So, it is a statistical inference about the testing of hypothesis. There are two ways you can perform the testing of hypothesis. One method is that you can go for the likelihood ratio test, and another is nothing but deviance. Okay. And if you are actually, I would like to convey here, even I have already told you that there is a close connection between the likelihood ratio test and deviance. Only the some nomenclatures are changing. So in likelihood ratio test, you have obtained the likelihood for a full model, if you remember, and likelihood of a restricted model. Aisa kiya hai na? Likelihood ratio L is nothing but, isko aapne kaha tha, lambda kaha tha na? Lambda is nothing but likelihood under complete parametric space divided by likelihood under the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis aapne rakha tha na, sample space omega. This is a parametric space and this is the under the null hypothesis. So you are just taking the ratio of likelihood under the omega. Yahan pe likha hai, isko inhone kya kaha hai ki it is a full model. That means you are considering all the parameters. And reduced models means under it not mein aap kya karte hai, some parameters equal to zero. Jaise aap aisa likhte hai. Suppose I am interested to test this hypothesis. F not beta equal to zero. Jabki mere model ke andar kitne parameters hai? Beta 0 and beta 1. So if I am considering this both the parameters and then calculated the likelihood, it is known as the L capital omega. If I am calculated the likelihood under eth naught, that means wherever the beta is there, I will substitute into the likelihood is 0. And whatever likelihood I get, it is the likelihood under the eth naught. Okay. So in this setup, it is known as a likelihood under the full model because I am considering all the parameters, and likelihood under restricted model because I have applied the restriction that beta 1 equal to 0. So when you take the twice of this ln of, aapne aisa padha hai na, twice of ln. Aap logon ne likelihood mein aise padha hoga shayad, if I am not mistaken, you have studied that. लैम्डा इज इक्वल टू ऐसे नहीं पढ़ा है आपने, आपने पढ़ा है एस एल एच एल ओमेगा डिवाइड बाय एल कैपिटल ओमेगा, ऐसे ही पढ़ा है ना? एंड देन यू से दैट माइनस 2 ln लैम्डा इज एसिम्प्टोटिकली पाई स्क्वायर. पाई स्क्वायर विद डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम क्या है? नंबर ऑफ पैरामीटर्स इन द पैरामेट्रिक स्पेस माइनस द नंबर ऑफ पैरामीटर्स अंडर एथ नॉट.
अच्छा,
ये आपने पढ़ा है. यहां पे इन्होंने क्या लिखा है, लाइक रेशियो में आपने यहाँ पे माइनस ट्वाइस किया था, इन्होंने माइनस की जगह प्लस कर दे तो क्या होगा?
तो वहाँ पे रिवर्स हो जाएगा.
रिवर्स हो जाएगा.
वन बाय लैम्ब्डा.
ऊपर रिवर्स हो जाएगा.
और वन बाय लैम्ब्डा होगा तो क्या होगा? ये रेशियो
एल ओमेगा
बाय एल ओमेगा अपॉन एल स्मॉल ओमेगा.
एल स्मॉल ओमेगा.
सही है ना?
हाँ.
यस सर.
तो नथिंग, दे हैव जस्ट चेंज दी sign and then return. Okay, So what I mean to tell you that in here they consider it as a full models and RM tends for the restricted. So whatever we have studied in the inference, omega means we have some restriction, and capital omega, that means there is no restriction. All the parameters are there. So this is likelihood for the full model and this is likelihood for the restriction. So that is what they are seeing. और वही का वही अगर हम हमारे सेटअप में ले जाते हैं तो हमने इसको क्या कहा है, twice of ls minus lm.
lm set the deviance.
LS is nothing but the log likelihood of a saturated model and log likelihood under restricted model is nothing but
deviance.
ठीक है, तो हम सीधा उसमें ही चलते हैं. This is we have obtained whenever we are interested to test the hypothesis. Okay, the goodness of fit test of the logistic regression model can also be assessed using a likelihood pressure test procedure that we have already said. This test compares the current model to a saturated models where each unique covariate pattern is allowed to have its own parameters. These parameters are success or failure. So aapko ye pi i kya hai, to yi upon ni. Yi is the number of success and ni is the number of observation associated with the ith covariate. So we have obtained this pi i, it is the probability. So deviance is nothing but we have already discussed the deviance. So twice of log of saturated model, likelihood of saturated model divided by the
log of full model
to yahan galat likha hai, it is the model consideration aayega. Full model तो नहीं लिख सकते. We are saying that it is a model under consideration. It is not full model. It is a model LM. Model under consideration. That means we wrote it is a LM. LM is nothing but log of L capital M. Okay. So this is nothing but the and we have already obtained the form of deviance. In a binary logistic regression, it is a twice of this. हमें ये मिला था, याद है सबको? We have already derived. Okay, and in this, if you substitute yi equal to zero, what happen? If you take yi equal to zero, this part is zero. Okay, under this yi, so this quantity is zero. If you are writing ni equal to zero, ni equal to not zero, ni equal to yi. So ni minus yi is zero, zero into this quantity is zero. That means there you have a two case. If you take y equal to zero, you have the inner deviance which contribute, this quantity will contribute. Okay, and if you have a y equal to n, in deviance which quantity contribute, this quantity will contribute. Okay, so we already obtained that the deviance saving the chi square with how many degree of freedom, n minus p, where p is nothing but the number of parameters in the models. Okay, what is the null hypothesis? Small value of the deviance ki value small hai, iska matlab kya hua? If deviance is small, it means p value kya hogi? ज्यादा होगी, क्योंकि डेविएंस स्मॉल है तो हाइपोथेसिस क्या होगी? एक्सेप्ट होगी तो प्रोबेबिलिटी वैल्यू क्या होगी? 0.05 से ज्यादा होगी. तो स्मॉल द डेविएंस, दैट मींस पी वैल्यू इज ग्रेटर देन 0.05, इट मींस दैट नल हाइपोथेसिस एक्सेप्टेड. नल हाइपोथेसिस एक्सेप्टेड इट मींस दैट द मॉडल प्रोवाइड्स सैटिस्फैक्टरी फिट टू द डेटा. तो व्हाट इज द नल हाइपोथेसिस इन द डेविएंस? मॉडल फिट्स वेल to data. So that is our null hypothesis. And if p value exceed alpha, we accept h naught. That means models provide the satisfactory, or the model fits satisfactory to the data, or it is adequately fit to the data. While large value of the deviance imply that the current model is not adequate. Kab? When there is a large value of deviance. Okay, So it is saying that current model is not fit well to the data. तो जब हम कहते हैं करंट मॉडल फिट नहीं हो रहा है तो इसका मतलब क्या है? We need to add some more variables in the models so that that model should provide the better fit to the data. Okay, I told you that D is nothing but the deviance, so we call them as the residual deviance, and residual deviance divided by the degree of freedom, the ratio of D upon N minus P is nothing but it is the estimate of a sigma square. Okay, and if the sigma square is greater than unity, then also we say that the current model is not adequately fit to the data. तो आपको जब आप मॉडल फिटिंग कर रहे हैं आपको देखना है कि अगर सिग्मा स्क्वायर की वैल्यू ग्रेटर देन वन या लेस देन वन आता है तो इट मीन्स दैट द मॉडल इज नॉट फिटिंग वेल टू द डेटा. सो दैट यू हैव टू आल्सो सी. ओके, एनी क्वेश्चंस अप टू दिस एनीवन?
No sir.
So based on deviance you can take the decision. हम इसमें अभी नहीं पढ़ेंगे, ये example में बाद में जाएंगे. थोड़ा आगे बढ़ते हैं. तो हमने डेवियंस के बेस पे टेस्टिंग ऑफ हाइपोथेसिस किसके ऊपर से डिसाइड किया? बेस्ड ऑन डेवियंस. ओके, वी ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट डेवियंस इज मेनली यूजफुल फॉर द नेस्टेड काइंड ऑफ कंपैरिजन ऑफ मॉडल. जैसे आपका एक मॉडल है मॉडल वन एंड मॉडल टू. What is your model? Model 1 आपके पास है beta 0 plus beta 1 x1. And model 2 आपके पास क्या है? Beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. ठीक है? So, first model is a sub-model of the second model. So, can we say that the first model is a sub-model of second model? Yes. So, m1 and m2 are nested type model. So if I have this two, if I will develop the models, I will call the deviance is d1, and this is called deviance for the model 2 is a d2. Sometimes we also seen use the notation skill deviance s1 and s2. Okay, so wo jo bhi aap use karo. So if I am saying that in general, if I am writing for the second model, beta having a three parameter, beta 0, beta 1, beta 2. And if I will divide this into the two part, beta 1 and beta 2. What is the beta 1 contain? Beta 1 contains first two element and beta 2 contain one element. That means this two contain in the beta 1 and this is the beta 2. तो ये आपका क्या हो गया है कि यू हैव पार्टीशन योर वेक्टर इनटू द टू पार्ट, वन हैविंग ए टू पैरामीटर्स एंड अनदर हैविंग ए वन पैरामीटर. तो यहां पे भी वैसी ही बात हो रही है कि वेन एवर यू हैव द लिनियर प्रेडिक्टर्स एक्स बीटा, नाउ एक्स बीटा इज डिवाइड इनटू द टू पार्ट, एक्स बीटा वन, एक्स वन बीटा वन एंड एक्स टू बीटा टू. कैसे? तो ऐसे ये आपका x है, ठीक है, इसके अंदर आपके पास कितने एलिमेंट है? x1, x2, up to xp. These are all the, because there are p covariates are there, so x is of order n cross p, each having n elements. x1 contain the n elements for the first variable and x2 contain the n element for the second variables, likewise. And you have a beta vector is something like you have written it is a beta 1, beta 2, beta p. Okay. So now we are dividing your x into the two part. You call them as x. It is not the vector. It is simply a x1 and x2. So what is the order? It has the r columns and it has a p minus r column. And here how many rows? It has a n rows. So order of x is a n cross p. What is the order of x1? It is a n cross r. And what is the order of x2? It is a n cross. क्या है इसमें कितने कॉलम है p माइनस r. So it is a p minus r. So you partition into the two. Why? Because you partition your beta into the two part, beta 1 and another is a beta 2. Where beta 1 contain how many elements? Beta 1, beta 2 up to beta r. And this is beta r plus 1 up to beta p. So you partition into the two part. This having a r elements and this having a p minus r. Okay. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So what happened? I have a data matrix having a n element and the p variables. So I have partitioned this particular data matrix into two part. We call them as x1 and x2. X1 matrix having n element with r columns or r variable, and x2 having a n element with the p minus r rest variables. Okay. So of course, if I am partitioning this x into the two part, I have to partitioning the beta into the two part. So I have partitioned beta into the two vector, beta 1 and beta 2. Beta 1 contain the first r parameters and beta 2 contain the last p minus r parameters. So that is what I have written here. If I have this x beta, तो आपके पास अभी क्या है? X beta. तो x में क्या है आपके पास? X1, X2. Beta के पास क्या है? आपके पास beta 1 and beta 2. So what will you write? X1 beta 1 plus X2 beta. ऐसा हम क्यों कर रहे हैं? बिकॉज आई एम ओनली इंटरेस्टेड टू नो वॉट इज द इंपैक्ट ऑफ बीटा टू. बीटा टू मीन्स वॉट इज द इंपैक्ट ऑफ एक्स टू. सपोज मेरे पास मॉडल है जिसके अंदर ऑलरेडी देर आर आर वेरिएबल्स आर देर. नाउ वॉट इज द इंपैक्ट ऑफ द पी माइनस आर अदर वेरिएबल्स ऑन द मॉडल्स. शुड आई एंटर दिस वेरिएबल फॉर द मॉडल डेवलपमेंट और नॉट? जैसे यहां पर ले लो, तो यहां पर हमारा बीटा वन में क्या आया? इट इज द टू एलिमेंट बीटा जीरो एंड बीटा वन. और यहाँ पे बीटा टू में क्या आया? इट इज अ बीटा टू ओनली. सो नाउ द माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी दिस मॉडल. शुड आई नेसेसरी टू ऐड दिस एक्स टू इन माय मॉडल डेवलपमेंट? तो आपने तो ऑलरेडी कंपेयर किया है डेवियंस के बेस पे. तो यहाँ पे बीटा टू में सिर्फ एक ही है. सपोज मेरे पास मॉडल ऐसा होता तो मेरे पास एक एक्स वन वेरिएबल है कि भाई ट्रीटमेंट एंड एक्टिव ड्रग आर इंपॉर्टेंट. बट शुड आई नीड टू ऐड द एज ऑफ द रिस्पोंडेंट, इनकम ऑफ द रिस्पोंडेंट, स्कूलिंग इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द रिस्पोंडेंट, एजुकेशन लेवल, हाउ मेनी इयर्स ऑफ द स्कूलिंग, whether these alls are really helpful to improve the patient life. Okay, so whenever I am interested to go for the subset of parameters, now I am interested to go for the subset of parameters, I have divided the parameters into the two part, beta 1 and beta 2. So I have divided into the two part, one contain the r parameters, another contain the p minus r parameters. So I have divided into this. And if I'm only interested to test this subset, I'm saying that there is no impact of the last p minus r variables on my models. So I wish to go for the testing of hypothesis of subset of parameters. Lekin which test applicable? I'm using the deviance. Okay, so that is what they are saying, that if I have the linear predictors x beta, I am just partitioning into the two part subset like beta 1 and beta 2. So my eta can be written in this x1 beta 1 plus x2 beta 2, where beta 1 contains the full model, contains the p parameters, and beta 1 contains p minus r parameters. Mera yahan pe galti ho gaya, maine r pehle likha hai, it is a p minus r. This is the उन्होंने P माइनस R ये लिखा है, एंड दिस इज ओनली R. दिस इज P माइनस R. दे हैव कंसीडर P माइनस R, एंड सेकंड हैविंग ए R एलिमेंट. दिस इज P माइनस R, दिस इज R. ओके, तो फर्स्ट X1 कंटेन दी हाउ मेनी? X1 कंटेन दी P माइनस R. Beta 1 contains P minus R of the parameters, and beta 2 contains the R of these parameters. And the columns of X1 and X2 contain the variable associated with these parameters. So X1 contains the how many variables? It is containing the P minus R variables, which are associated with the P minus R parameters. X2 contains the P minus R variables,
X2 R.
X2 contain the R variables associated with the R parameters. Okay. So what is my null hypothesis? I'm interested to say that there is no impact of the last R variables on the model development. Okay. So there is no impact of the R variables. So for that, I have tested this hypothesis at not beta 2 equal to 0, H1 beta not equal to 0. So what is my full linear predictors? My full linear predictor is this X beta. But under the null hypothesis, what is my linear predictors? It is a X1 beta 1. So I can say it is a linear predictor under reduce, or the null hypothesis, we call them as a reduced model linear predictors. So it is nothing but X1 beta 1. When I have a full model, I can calculate the deviance. So deviance, because all the parameters are present, so it is a deviance of beta. And if I have considered only the beta 1 linear predictors, then I have it is a deviance of beta 1. Okay. Now I am interested to find out. अब मुझे आपको बताना, आपको मुझे बताना है कि ये दोनों में से बड़ा कौन है, छोटा कौन सा है? Out of these two, which has the higher value? What is the relation between the deviance of beta and deviance of beta 1? What is the relation?
Deviance of beta is greater than?
Deviance of?
Beta is larger than beta 1.
Deviance ki definition kya hai? It is a twice of log likelihood under saturated models and model consideration. तो जब आप मॉडल कंसिडरेशन में व्हेन यू टेक ऑल द पैरामीटर्स, तो वो क्या हो गया, सैचुरेटेड मॉडल जितना ही हो गया, तो डेवियंस क्या हो गया, ऑलमोस्ट जीरो हो गया. ठीक है, तो व्हेन यू ऐड मोर पैरामीटर्स, डेवियंस इज डिक्रीजिंग. तो सबसे ज्यादा पैरामीटर किस में है? डेवियंस ऑफ बीटा में. इसमें पी पैरामीटर तो ये आएगा लेस देन. ओके, एंड दैट इज हाउ इफ आई एम इंटरेस्टेड टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द contribution of the last R parameters or the R variables in the deviance, so it is nothing but d beta 2 by d beta 1 is equal to ye aayega na, mujhe R ka dekhna hai to deviance of beta 2 nikalna padega, but conditioning data beta 1, to ye kya hoga, kiska zyada hai, to deviance of beta 1 is larger and deviance of beta is smaller, so isko maine minus kiya hai. So I am getting that what is the contribution of the last R parameters. So what is the degree of freedom of deviance of beta 1? An observation, how many parameters beta 1 mein? P minus R. Deviance mein kitne hai? Jab all parameters are degree of freedom is N minus P. Dono ka minus karo to kya hoga? This is n minus p plus r. Here minus n plus p. This plus p is cancel out. दिस इज माइनस एन इज कैंसिल आउट, तो क्या बचा आर. तो डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम इज नथिंग बट डी आर. सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू जस्ट व्हेनेवर यू परफॉर्म द सबसेट ऑफ रिग्रेशन मॉडल्स यूजिंग द डेवियंस, यू हैव अ फुल मॉडल्स, तो यू हैव टू फर्स्ट कैलकुलेट द डेवियंस ऑफ द फुल मॉडल्स एंड देन यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द डेवियंस ऑफ द रिड्यूस्ड मॉडल्स. Just take the difference of deviance of reduced model and deviance of full models, that is giving the deviance of the or the contribution of the variables under eth naught in the deviance, and the degree of freedom is nothing but the, it is the successive difference of the degree of freedom of the deviance under the reduced models and deviance under the full model, so it is a r. So what is the distribution of a deviance? So we have already seen that the deviance has a chi-square distribution. So by additive property, the difference having also a chi-square distribution, what is the degree of freedom? It is the degree of freedom of a difference of degree of freedom. So that is how it has the chi-square R distribution. So it is distributed as a chi-square with R degree of freedom. So of course, this should be compared with the critical value of chi-square alpha. So it is saying that if deviance is exceed the chi-square alpha r, reject the null hypothesis, otherwise accept the null hypothesis. Suppose your aapki null hypothesis reject hoti hai, what is your decision? If your null hypothesis is rejected, what is your decision?
Not
reject to iska matlab beta 2 is not
value is important.
Beta 2 zero nahi. Yes, exactly. When the beta 2 is not zero, it means that the all the parameters are contained in the beta 2 vectors are not simultaneously zero. That means the variables associated with this regressions are of a important. That means we have to add the regressions. Okay. So, यहाँ पे आपको एक छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल दिया है. हमने पहला जो ओरिंग फेल्यूर वाला data liya, so initially we fit the data and we got this. Yahan pe galti hai, 10 point aage 10 reh gaya, to ye aapko mila tha product. Suppose now we say that no, only linear term of temperature is not important, there is a impact of a quadratic term. So I have added the x square. So my linear predictors become the eta equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x 1. And because I have said it is a quadratic term, so I have written it is a beta 1 1 x 1 square. Okay. So if I am giving x 1, so it is x 1 square. If I am keeping only x, then it is a x square. So what happened? I have added one more variable. So first I have to calculate the deviance for this, and then I have to calculate the deviance for this linear predictors. So you have obtained. So you can see that the this is your eta equal to x beta. It has partition into two parts. The first part is this and second part will be this. Now we are trying to test the hypothesis beta 1 1 equal to beta 1 1 equal to 0. So beta 1 1 0, it means that I have to obtain the deviance based on this. So deviance of beta is kya hua? See, I have considered the beta 0, beta 1 and beta 1 1. So that is I got the deviance of beta. How many observations? There are 7 observations. 17 observation, how many parameters? Beta 0, beta 1 and beta 1 1, so 3 parameters. So 17 minus 13, degree of freedom is 14. Okay, now I have considered the reduced form of linear predictors. So reduced kya hua? Kyunki maine ye rakha, to kya hoga? Reduced form mein beta 0 and beta 1 1 x hi aega. Okay, because this is nothing but the x2 beta 2 in this. This is x1 beta 1, this is x2 beta 2. Okay. So what is the linear the reduced form deviance? So it's a d of beta 1. So I told you that the reduced having the higher deviance than the full deviance. So you can see that 15.75 and 15.31, So it is this. But what is the degree of freedom of this? So there are how many parameters?
Three.
What is the degree of freedom? It is a n minus p minus r. Okay, so n is 17. How many p? It is a 3. And r कितना है? 1. तो ये कितना degree of freedom हुआ इसका? कितना हुआ? 15 ना? Okay. तो आपको degree of freedom इसकी कितनी होगी? 15 minus 14. That will you get 1 degree of freedom. So this having the r equal to 1. Or you can say that वहाँ से भी आपको degree of freedom नहीं calculate करना है तो under f naught. कितने पैरामीटर थे उतनी डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम होगी. देयर इज वन पैरामीटर, सो देयर इज अ वन डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम. इन अर्लियर सेशन इट वाज अ आर पैरामीटर्स. लास्ट आर पैरामीटर्स की इंपैक्ट क्या है वो देखना था. तो डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम कितनी थी? आर थी. तो व्हाई आर इन दैट वे आल्सो. एंड व्हेन यू कैलकुलेट द पी वैल्यू एसोसिएटेड विद द आई स्क्वायर दिस पर्टिकुलर इट इज अ 0.506 व्हिच इज ग्रेटर देन 0.05. तो दैट मींस नल हाइपोथेसिस एक्सेप्टेड. It means that there is no impact of quadratic term temperature in the model development. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So, वो actually क्या हो गया? आपने individual testing कर लिया ना? Using the subset of regressors of Davian. Individual हुआ ना? मुझे quadratic variable की impact है कि नहीं देखना है तो I can just see in that way. तो उसके बाद हम देखेंगे टेस्ट ऑफ इंडिविजुअल टेस्ट. अगेन यहां से जो आप रिजल्ट मिलेगा वही यहां से मिलेगा. दैट वी विल प्रूव. एंड दिस इज गिवन बाय द वाल. सो इट इज नोन एज द वाल स्टैटिस्टिक्स. ये मैंने डिस्कस किया है बट हम देखेंगे उसको नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में. एनी क्वेश्चन एनीवन?
नो सर.
अप्लाइड वाले सुन रहे हैं?
Yes, sir.
Any question?
No, sir.
No, sir. Question, sir.
No, sir.